Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
Good morning. It is Friday morning. You made it through the week, or whatever time you're watching it on Friday, and we're heading into the weekend. So what do you got planned? I'm going to do a live show tonight, live on the air on my other channel, and then I'm going to probably start my birthday week. So I'm going to have lots of fun. So, and what are you doing? I would like to know. I'm curious. Or is it nosy? It's one of those. So one of the questions that people have been asking me is, Peter, what would you buy if you didn't buy the Sony E1, which is the camera you're looking at right now? And let me tell you about that camera just for two seconds, okay? I've had it for a week. It's a week old. And when I turned it on at the beginning of the week, I haven't turned it off since. Well, I have turned it off. I've had to turn it off to take it outside, do my walking around the backyard, and all that kind of stuff. But I put a dummy battery in there, which gives me power from the wall, or a USB-C cable, which they didn't give me. The cheap wads. Can you imagine them not giving me a USB-C cable? And the camera lists for what? $2,200? Oh my God. Talk about cheap. I've been running it all week. Not even a hint. Not even a slight hint as to an overheating warning. It's going to overheat. It's not going to overheat. I'm constantly thinking, what is the camera going to do? I need to know. So I looked, and I've been keeping my eye on it the entire week. I am purposely not turning it. Even overnight, I leave it on. And I've left the computer. Everything in here has been on for a whole week. Everything else is going like, dang, we got a new camera. Now we all have to suffer. Well, yeah, everybody suffered in here. All the cameras have suffered. So what can I tell you? What can I tell you? So not even a hint of overheating, not even the warning. You know, most cameras will give you a warning if you're going to overheat by giving you like a thermometer or something to that effect. By the way, that's one of the cameras that I would be considering under $1,000. But back to what I was talking about, okay? So not even a heating warning. It's been such a good boy. Now, does that mean this camera isn't going to overheat ever? No, that doesn't mean that. That means that what they tried to do is scared the doo-doo out of me, the crapola out of me, by saying, oh, it overheats, Peter. It overheats, Peter. It overheats, Peter. Now I had it in my mind, it overheats, Peter. And not one time the entire week. I took it outside in the backyard in the middle of the day at 92 degrees. I took it and put it in here. I brought it in my bedroom. I brought it in the kitchen. When I went out, I took it with me in the car. No overheating warning. Now, I didn't have it plugged into the wall when I was in the car. That was with a regular battery. Okay, there. I mean, give me a little credit. I do know a little bit, but when it's in here, sitting on the tripod like it's doing right now, it's being run by the wall, okay? So what camera would I buy? And why wouldn't you buy this camera? Well, I can think of a few reasons. Most of them, I don't even agree with. I did buy the camera. Hello? Okay. But we'll go through some of them anyway, and then I'll tell you what would I buy instead. So one of the things that people have said is that it's got 12 megapixels. And like, oh my God, I think I'm going to faint. 12 megapixels. Who in their right mind ever heard of 12 megapixels in a camera? I did weddings. For years, at 6 and 8 megapixels, and the sensors were not as good as the sensors we got today, and the processors were not as good as the processors we got today, and we didn't have dual ISO back then, so it's a whole new ball game. So these people are just lip syncing. So this YouTuber says, no good. So the other guy goes, no good. It's good. It's fine. Honestly, You can take pictures with this camera. You can blow them up to your heart's content. And if you cross the boundaries, then you got a problem. But then there's even solutions for that. Do you want a new camera or do you want a used camera? If you want a used camera and you want to spend around $1,000, hey, the guy that you're looking at right now, that is a huge contender. This camera is a $2,300 camera, $1,999, $2,000 camera. You can get them used, and they're awesome. And it's got the entire Nikon system behind it. I'm talking about the Nikon Z6. Now, let's say, no, but Peter, I want a new camera. Don't give me a used camera. I just want a brand new camera. This one, I bought it. This one's mine. It's the Panasonic S5 Mark II. One of the best cameras you could buy right now is this camera. So why did I need the E1? Are you trying to cause trouble here? Are you related to my wife, Maibo? Oh, better not wake her up. Okay, so anyway, that camera is awesome. Now, how about if you didn't want to spend a really high amount? This guy right here is called the Sony E10. That would be the little brother to the other camera. And yes, it's got a lot more megapixels, almost double. But it is a crop sensor and it doesn't do 60p, and that's fine. I don't have a problem with that. So why didn't you stay with that? I don't know, boys and their toys. I wanted a full frame camera. And then when they started showing me some of the stuff that the image stabilization did on that camera, it actually is better than this camera. And this is one of the best image stabilizations you can get. This one is better. Oh my God, what are they doing in 2023? And I'm gonna be 70 years old this week. I don't have that much life left. I won't be here to see what you guys are gonna see. I feel left out. I am sad. I wanna see the new stuff as it comes out. So let's go and do a proper list, okay? If I didn't buy this camera, the first camera that I would actually look at is the Nikon that hasn't even come out yet, ZF. It's supposed to come out according to Larry. Larry, thank you. He left a comment for me in my comments. Thank you, guys. I do read the comments. So leave me a comment and be nice. I only want nice comments. So he said that it's coming out October 23rd. Well, the official date is November 1st, or actually October 31st. So November 1st, if they're late by a day. So, but he said he got notification, means he's got it on order, which means I could say, please use my links in the description below. It helps me so much. It helps me with activity. It helps me with YouTube activity. It helps me with the people that wherever you go, if you go to Adorama, they realize, hey, Peter sent us somebody. He sent us somebody over here, and they keep track. They keep score. They keep records. So go and click my links, even if you're only shopping, window shopping. They'll get the message. They came from Peter Gregg's site. So I want to say thank you. It's down underneath the video in the description in the more box. Down there. Okay? So do that. I would also consider the Canon R8. Yep, that's another contender. Full frame, and it will do 60p full frame without a crop. Imagine that. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. There you go. The Canon R8, and they got some nice wide lenses. They got a 16 millimeter. The camera's a light camera. Image stabilization, not even close to my new Sony E1. Not even close. This one's got better image stabilization in it there, okay, than the R8. So, yep, that's why I'm saying the R8 is a contender. The used Z6 is a contender. So we got some really good stuff going on, and that's a happy thing. Yes, I got to tell you a secret. It's hard to buy a bad camera today. You look at any camera since 2020, 2021, it's hard to find a bad one. It really is. You really have to study. So the Nikon ZFC, the Canon R8 is another contender. The on the used market, the Nikon Z6. On the new market, but a lower price, it would be the Sony E10. And that is the baby brother to the E1 that I purchased. And that would be on par with this guy here, which I purchased. So what do I have against this? I bought this one. This could be on your overall list. The Panasonic S5 Mark II. It's got to be the Mark II, okay? So the Panasonic S5 Mark II, that would be very, very high on the list. But I already bought it. So I'm not actually shopping to see what other camera I could buy because I already bought it. So that's not fair to the Panasonic. Now, the Canon R8 will do the 60p in full frame. That I could run the entire Christmas room with and give you all kinds of angles. I can do 60p in a crop with the Z6. It's got the ability to do that in a firmware upgrade. See, Nikon will upgrade their firmware. Sony is like pulling teeth. You very rarely are gonna get a firmware upgrade. So those are the cameras. Okay, so this is the E10. So I can actually do all my videos with four of these cameras. And it's $698 a piece, and you got to get some lenses. You can have one or two of them, and you got yourself an amazing show going. So you do have the contention of the used cameras also. There is some good stuff out there. Now, if I didn't answer your question, or you do have another question, make a comment and ask your question down there, where it says show more, or whatever the words are these days. They change them so often, I don't even know, okay? So for myself, I want a very light, small camera, the Sony E1. I want a camera that's got second to none image stabilization, second to none, the Sony E1. I want a camera that will do full frame 60p, not because I shoot it, but because I do B-roll with it, and I put it on a 24p timeline, and I got slow motion, just like that, with sound, the Sony E1. I want a camera that I can actually put in my pocket if I put the right lens on it, the Sony E1. How about if we do some unreasonable stuff? I want a camera that I can actually stand up here, walk around, and it'll follow me around the room by itself, the Sony E1. I want a camera that's great, almost second to none, in low light, the Sony E1. It's got dual ISO, and it's got two sets. One is for its S-Log 3, and that is 640 and 12,800. You can put it to 12,800. I'm almost going to laugh. And it starts back as if it was at 640. So dual ISO means that this one and this one are very similar, almost alike. Probably not exactly, okay? So in S-Log 3, ISO 640 and ISO 12,800 are very similar, okay? Then if you put it in HLG, ISO 400 and ISO 2000 it's like starting over again. So if you're shooting at ISO 1600, don't. If you're an HLG, that's a mode in here, okay? Don't shoot, you know, at ISO 1600. Move it up to 2000 and run the camera in HLG mode. So HLG means you're going to have to add a little bit of color because it's purposely dumbing it down to give you a little more dynamic range. You can do it though. You can do it. Trust me, you can. Okay. So all those things is the reason and more why I bought the E1. So if they took this camera and they made it all completely plastic, kept everything else the same. Okay. Take off one third the weight. You might have bought that one. It's not going to fit in my pocket, but I could use all my Canon lenses that are not the new mirrorless Canon lenses on that camera. As a matter of fact, there's one on there right now. Okay. So if they take half the weight. Now, if you say, well, you know, that camera doesn't exist. Well, this one does. Okay, so this is the Sony E10. A light camera, it's got baby lenses, it everything except image stabilization, and it doesn't do 60p, so I really can't do my B-roll. I could drop the quality if I wanted to and go into, what do they call that? High definition only to do some B-roll. But then it's missing some functionality. Like I like to have a setting 1, setting 2, and setting 3. Well, on this one, it's got all that. I think it's got either 5 or 6. And then the same thing for this guy. It's got 6 also. All right, so that's kind of my list. If I forget one, if I didn't include your favorite, don't be offended. Doesn't mean it's not a great camera. I've said it before, I'll say it again. Winner, winner, chicken dinner. You cannot buy a bad camera that's 2021 and newer, or even 2020 and newer, all the way to today, plus the cameras that are coming out. What a wonderful time to be alive. Bye-bye, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Later, Gator. Whoosh!
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching.
As far as the E1 goes, the digital image stabilization, it's not digital. It's dynamic. It's dynamic image stabilization. So let's try that again, okay? So as far as the camera goes, the image stabilization, that digital image that, oh my God, I can't believe I just did that. It is dynamic active stabilization. Do I have to write it down for you? I will. Are you the dummy in the room? Hello? And one of my other choices would be the Canon E1. Bah! Canon E1! It's a Sony E1. Canon doesn't make an E1. So what's wrong with the Canon E1? I have nothing against the Canon E1. That's actually crazy. Okay, let's go. Let's go. Let's get back on the road. Okay, pause. One of the best used cameras that you can buy today is this guy right there, the Sony Z6, except for one thing. It's not a Sony Z6. It's a Nikon. Read the sign, dummy. I got it on the screen for you right there. Reach for it. It's a Nikon Z6. What? It must be birthday fever. I don't know what it is. All right, let's get back to the show. So I do read the comments, and Harry even wrote Harry Zapata, except it's not Harry Zapata, it's Larry. Hey, Larry, you out there? I renamed you. I can't put this, got to be cut out. Okay, back to the show. Larry with an L, not Larry with an H, because that would be Harry. And Harry is not Larry, and Larry is not Harry. Actually, Larry and Harry don't even know each other. They've never met. It's not even possible. They don't live in the same state. I don't know where Harry lives, and I don't know where Larry lives, but they can't possibly be in the same state. Now, are you going to stop acting like an idiot and get back to running your show, or are you just going to ramble on and on and on? Shut up. You're fired. You're fired. The camera hasn't even given me an inclination of overheating. I have had it running constantly for one freaking month, and it not even... Months? I've only had the camera a week. Yeah, I've been running it for a month, guys. Oh, wow. That we do miracles here. Praise Jesus. I do miracles. No, it's not me. Anyway, that was one for the blooper. You think I can get my act together? It's the battery. It's got to be the battery. And I don't mean the battery in the camera. It's the battery in the Peter. I got to put a new battery in the Peter because the Peter is just not working right tonight. Even though it's morning. See, I can't even do a blooper properly. It's morning. It's not night. It's morning. Good morning. Good night.